Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Bryan Sings Broadway. Sure, I came out here to make my name. Wanted my pool, my dose of fame. Wanted my parking space at Warner's. But after a year of one-room hell, a Murphy bed, a rancid smell, wallpaper peeling at the corners. Sunset Boulevard, twisting boulevard, secretive and rich, a little scary. Sunset Boulevard, tempting boulevard, waiting there to swallow the unwary. Dreams are not enough to win a war. Out here they're always keeping score. Beneath the tan the battle rages. Smile, a rented smile, fill someone's glass. Kiss someone's wife, kiss someone's ass. We do whatever pays the wages. Sunset Boulevard, Headline Boulevard, getting here is only the beginning. Sunset Boulevard, Jackpot Boulevard, once you've won, you have to go unwinning. You think I've sold out? Dead right, I've sold out. I've just been waiting for the right offer. Comfortable quarters, regular rations, 24-hour, 5-star room service. And if I'm honest, I like the lady. I can't help being touched by a volley. I'm treading water, taking the money, watching her sunset. Well, I'm a writer. LA's changed a lot over the years since those brave gold rush pioneers came in those creaky covered wagons. Far as they could go, end of the line, their dreams were yours, their dreams were mine, but in those dreams were hidden dragons. Sunset Boulevard, frenzy boulevard, swamped with every kind of false emotion. Sunset Boulevard, frenzy boulevard, just like you will wind up in the ocean. She was sinking fast, I threw a rope. Now I have suits and she has hope. It seemed an elegant solution. One day this must end, it isn't real. Still I'll enjoy a hearty meal before tomorrow's execution. Sunset Boulevard, ruthless boulevard, destination for the stony hearted. Sunset Boulevard, lethal boulevard, everyone's forgotten how they started. Here on Sunset Boulevard. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. If you don't know me, which I think all 102 of you are friends. My name is Bryan Chesters, and I am so, so grateful for each and every one of you for being here this evening. This has been a crazy week for Mr. Stephen Applegate on the piano. And let's give it up for Sammy on audio and lights. We've got Chris and Ron that are giving us our 5-camera stream. Hello out to all our streamers and on-demand watchers. And I want to thank Irene for helping here at Feinsteins. It's been a crazy week. My love goes out to Fiamma. I hope you're watching right now. She is my singing partner. And as a lot of you know, she became ill about a week and a half ago or so, right before our Chicago gig. And unfortunately, she wasn't able to do that. I called on a friend that I hadn't sang with since high school, but she's got, you know, Broadway credits and stuff, and we put together a show in a couple hours, and everybody was very happy there, so it was wonderful. The same thing happened. We thought she could do this week, but I called on six or eight special friends that will be joining me shortly, and I am so honored that they're here to perform for you. You're going to love each and every one of them. But talking about Sunset Boulevard, so this was a show I did the first national tour way back when in the 90s. It was directed by, shut up, Jennifer. It was directed by Trevor Nunn, who you know, directed a couple little shows like Les Miserables and, gosh, Cats. So, you know, we weren't intimidated at all meeting him or working with him. But my audition experience was very stressful because it was the worst snowstorm New York City has ever seen. I know some of you have lived in New York, and I thought, well, for sure the audition's canceled. But no, I trudged through the rain and the snow, right, Pam? And I get there, and sure enough, there's a room full of actors because they'll go anywhere. And So after I was done singing, the show's choreographer, Bob Avion, who again choreographed the original Chorus Line with Michael Bennett and Dreamgirls, he turns and says, "Can you do a Sinead turn and land on a dime?" And I go, "You bet your ass." I don't even know if I knew what a Sinead turn was, but I was not going to let anything stop me from getting that show. Not a snowstorm or a Sinead turn. Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't, it isn't right, don't, it isn't nice. Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't walk on the grass, don't disturb the peace, don't skate on the ice. Well, I say do. I say walk in the grass it was meant to feel. I say sail. Tilt to the windmill, and if you fail, you fail. Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't get out of line. When they say that, then, baby, that's a sign. 9 times out of 10, baby, you are doing just fine. Now make just a ripple. You come on, be brave. And this time a ripple, and next time a wave. Sometimes you have to start small. You're climbing the tiniest wall, and maybe you're going to fall, but it's better than not starting at all. Everybody says no, everybody says stop, everybody says mustn't rock the boat, mustn't touch a thing. Everybody says no, everybody says wait, everybody says can't fight City Hall, can't upset the cart, can't laugh at the king. Well, I say try. I say laugh at the king so they make you cry. Lose your poise. Fall if you have to, but baby, make a noise. Everybody says no, everybody says can't. Everybody says wait around for miracles. That's the way the world is made. I insist on miracles. If you do them, miracles. Nothing to them. I say don't. Don't be afraid.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I love that song. That song, I think, got me through COVID. You know, it's just such a positive, you know, don't let people tell you what to do. You just do it. That was our mantra the last couple of weeks. So maybe a little tickling on the ivories, a little water music. Thank you. So,
a little story. Okay. So when I lived in New York, we were rehearsing Sunset Boulevard downtown Manhattan, and Fiamma actually tells the story, but I'll pretend like it was me. So she was in the elevator. The elevator got up to the fourth floor, and in wafts the music of Sunset Boulevard. She looks over, and she is standing next to Patti LuPone. And she looks, and Patti goes, "Oh, that show." Now, if you are unfamiliar with the history of Sunset Boulevard and Patti LuPone, let me explain. So she originated the role of Norma Desmond, the lead, in England. Hello, Natalie. At the West End. And she was scheduled to do the Broadway run. But Andrew Lloyd Webber, at the last minute, pulled the plug and said, "No, I want a bona fide movie star." So he put Glenn Close in the role. But nobody puts Patti in the corner. So she lawyered up, she got $1 million settlement, and $1 million every year the show ran on Broadway. Yeah. Good for her, right? Good for her. But
This did lead to the longest feud in Broadway history. Our relationships, they're hard. And they don't always go the way you think. It started out like a song. We started quiet and slow with no surprise. And then one morning I woke to realize we had a good thing going. It's not that nothing went wrong. Some angry moments, of course, well, just a few. But only moments, no more, because we knew we had this good thing going. And if I wanted too much, was that such a mistake? At the time, you never wanted enough. All right, tough, I don't make that a crime. And while you're going along, you take for granted some love will wear away. We took for granted a lot, but still I say we could have kept on growing instead of just kept on. We had a good thing going, going, gone.
Thank you.
Thank you. I told you, relationships, they're hard, but luckily I'm in a good one now, and you'll hear about that. Yeah, but you'll hear about that later. All right, well, staying on a little ballad train, this next song I would like to dedicate to Fiamma, because I normally get to sing it to her, so I'm sending her good healing vibes, and I'm gonna sing this to her.
Nothing's gonna harm you, not while I'm around. Nothing's gonna harm you, no sir, not while I'm around. Demons will charm you everywhere nowadays. I'll send them howling, I don't care, I got ways. No one's gonna hurt you, no one's gonna dare. Others may desert you, not to worry, whistle, I'll be there. Demons will charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing can harm you, not while I'm around. Being close and being clever ain't like being true. I don't want to, I would never hide a thing from you like song. Demons will charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing can harm you,
Not while I'm around. Thank you. All right, who can tell me what show that song's from? Where's our real music theater fans? Sweeney Todd, Sweeney Todd. Well, speaking of Sweeney Todd, I have my first special guest, which we met at UCLA, the second time, because the first time I was an undergrad with some of you, Natalie and Monica, but the second time I went back for my master's in acting, and I got to work and meet Linda. And let me tell you a little bit about her. She was in the original Broadway production of one of my favorite musicals, In a Most Unusual Way, Nine the Musical. Such a great show. And then they did the movie, you know, with Daniel. And she did that, and she did tours of Wicked and Beauty and the Beast. And she's not only an incredible performer, but she's also an incredible teacher and just a wonderful human being. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Linda Kerns.
Sweeney score for years. Did you come to hear a song, sir? Listen closely, or the lyrics make no sense. Phew, out of breath. Are the rhythms too intense? And don't even try to guess the pauses. See, you can't. Don't inhale for long, sir. I'd be helpless if my diction wasn't clipped. I'll slow down now. Would you like to see a script? Mind you, I can't hardly blame you. I've been spitting out most words on Broadway. I know why nobody can discern them. I should know. I learned them. Too good, though. The most words on Broadway. Even that's too quick. The most words on Broadway. Is the accent still too thick? The meter is dizzy. No time for relaxing. The business is busy. The syntax is taxing. The most words on Broadway. And no wonder with the public purse what it is. When it opens, never thought I'd live to see the day. No one felt that it was worse hearing strange syllables. What are squandered in a verse? Rice and Weber won a Tony. Doing business with a substitute for style. Lots of lyrics miss the music by a mile. Have to hand it to them, what I calls solid sold, turning Ava into gold. Argentine baloney. Just the thought of it's enough to make you bitch. And I'm telling you, Perone will make them rich. No denying Sondheim's hard, sir. Even harder with the most words on Broadway. Gaucho Pyle earned much more. Is that just depressing? The score is simplistic. Our taste is regressing. Well, let's be realistic. A genius of text. Who didn't write MAME? But the most words on Broadway are, sir, Sondheim's hard, Sondheim's hard.
Ladies and gentlemen, Linda Kerns. Awesome.
Thank you.
All right. Well, we are going to stay on the Sweeney Todd train. Natalie, this one's for you, because you every time, I have to tell you guys, I had this walk-in closet, and during COVID, we got through COVID because we would have these fabulous singing nights. And a lot of you have been to what Jennifer has called the Bedroom Bryan Lounge, because it was in my bedroom, and it was in the walk-in closet where the keyboard was. And we would like open the door like it was a veiled curtain, you know. But she had always asked me to sing the song, and I never did. So we're gonna do it now. This is Anthony's song. I feel you, Joanna. I feel you. I was half convinced I'd waken, satisfied enough to dream you. Happily, I was mistaken, Joanna. I'll steal you, Joanna. I'll steal you. Do they think that walls can hide you? Even now I'm at your window. Happily I was mistaken, Joanna. Joanna, and one day I'll steal you. Till I'm with you, then I'm with you there, buried sweetly in your yellow hair. Thank you. I love Sweeney Todd. I love it. So my next special guest, I'm going to give a little intro. She was in the original Broadway production of one of my favorite plays, Torch Song Trilogy, Harvey Firestein's big, you know, the success. And she also did Bubbling Brown Sugar, and she did the tour of the magic show, which I loved. But most recently, she's been doing voiceover work, and she is a voice on a new anime or animated series on HBO Max. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my friend, Susan Edwards Martin.
Thank you. I'm going to use the mic.
Yes.
Stand.
Perfect.
Hi, everybody. Isn't Bryan wonderful? Oh, my God. I'm quelling. He's doing so great. And Steven, wow, this is great. Okay. I had a dream about you, baby. It's gonna come true, baby. They think that we're through, but baby, you'll be swell, you'll be great. Gonna have the whole world on a plate. Starting here, starting now. Honey, everything's coming up roses. Clear the decks, clear the tracks. You've got nothing to do but relax. Blow a kiss, take a bow. Honey, everything's coming up roses. Now's your inning. Have the world on its ear. Set it spinning. That'll be just the beginning. Curtain up. Light the lights. You've got nothing to hit but the heights. You'll be swell. You'll be great. I can tell. Just you wait. That lucky star I talk about is due. Honey, everything for me and for you. You can do it. All you need is a hand. We can do it. Mama is gonna see to it. Curtain up, light the lights. We've got nothing to hit but the heights. I can tell, wait and see. There's the bell, follow me. And nothing's gonna stop us till we're through. Honey, everything's coming up. Roses and daffodils. Everything's coming up. Sunshine and Santa Claus. Everything's gonna be bright lights and lollipops. Everything's gonna be roses for me and for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Susan Edwards Martin. Woo! All right, so, all right, who can tell me what show that song's from? Gypsy. Well, speaking of Gypsy, Susan just learned this today because I asked her to, and we're gonna do a little bit of Together Wherever We Go, but first, we're gonna tell you how we met.
How did we meet?
How did we meet?
That was my cue. How did we meet?
Well, I will tell you. Some of you saw the production of Minnie's Boys at the Music Theater Guild, which is a great thank you, at the Alex Theater. And she played Minnie, and I played her husband. And not unlike the relationship between Herbie and Rose. Like, you know, he's always kind of the pass-along husband, you know, kind of. But I love singing the song with her, and we're gonna make some magic here.
All right, we're making it happen. Okay, if I don't know the words, I'm sure you all know it.
Wherever we go, whatever we do, we're gonna go through it together.
We may not go far, but sure as a star, we're gonna go through it together.
Wherever I go, I know she goes.
Wherever I go, I know he goes.
No fits, no fights, no feuds, and no egos. Amigos, together.
Through thick and through thin.
All out or all in.
And whether it's win, place, or show,
it's you for me and me for you. We'll muddle through whatever we do together, wherever we go. Ever I go, I know she goes.
It's true, it's true. Ever I go, I know he goes.
No fits, no fights, no feuds, and no egos. Amigos, together. All out or roll in.
And whether it's win, place, or show,
it's you for me and me for you. We'll muddle through whatever we do together, wherever, together, wherever we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Susan Edwards. Oh, we got a standing ovation. She literally just learned it today. That was amazing. Thank you.
Thank you, Steven.
Yay.
Thank you, Steven.
Thank you, Steven. Ladies and gentlemen, Steven Applegate. Give him those most applause. So this next song is from one of my favorite musicals, Into the Woods. And it's a story that Jack is telling about, you know, climbing up the beanstalk and seeing this whole new world. And I think the reason I really like this song is because most of my life I've felt like I was kind of climbing a giant beanstalk. I'm like, oh, this is cool. Oh, this is cool. And I'm constantly like searching for something that was out there. And I worked on cruise ships and I traveled the world. And And actually, after all those years, it was exhausting, I finally realized everything I needed was right here, inside of me. There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high and you look below the world you left and the things you know, little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, and the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you never dare, 'cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. And she gives you food and she gives you rest. She draws you close to her giant breast, and you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you made a friend and all, and you know she's big but you don't feel small, someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach stone, and you're really scared being all alone. It's then that you wish for the things you've known and the worlds you left and the things you own. The fun is done. You steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and you look below. The world you left begins to grow. The roof, the house, and your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen. You wish that you could live in between. But you're back again, only different than before. Not till the sky. There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky. Thank you, thank you. A lot of lyrics in that one, a lot of. So I was just in Chicago last week, my hometown. Any Chicagoans out there? Yay! And if I was actually staying right across the street from one of my favorite museums, the Art Institute, where you can find this amazing painting called Sunday in the Park with George. It's a beautiful painting, and we all, you know, in the 80s saw Ferris Bueller, and they're, you know, staring at all the little dots. And the thing, you know, I love about the musical that Stephen Sondheim wrote was that it truly explores the difficulty. Sometimes we have a lot of artists out there, and sometimes the difficulty between wanting to have your art, and it's something that you have to practice by yourself, but then you want a partner, and you want to have a relationship, and then sometimes, you know, your partner has to, like, ebb and flow with what it's like being an artist, and... And sometimes it gets a little messy, but anyway, this is a great song because he explores that. Yes, she looks for me. Good. Let her look for me to tell me why she left me, as I always knew she would. I had thought she understood. They have never understood, and no reason that they should. But if anybody could. Finishing the hat. How you have to finish the hat. How you watch the rest of the world from the window while you finish the hat. Mapping out a sky. What you feel like planning a sky. What you feel when voices that come from the window go. until they distance and die, until there's nothing but sky, and now you're always turning back too late from the grass or the stick or the dog or the light. Are the kind of woman willing to wait, not the kind that you want to find waiting to return you to the night. Dizzy from the height, coming from the hat, starting on a hat, entering the world of the hat, reaching through the world of the hat like a window. Back to this one from that, studying a face, stepping back to look at a face, leaves a little space in the way like a window, but to see, it's the only way to see. And when the woman that you wanted goes, you can say to yourself, will I give what I give? But a woman who won't wait for you knows that however you live, there's a part of you always standing by, mapping out a sky, finishing a hat, starting on a hat, finishing a hat. Look, I made a hat. Where there never was a hat.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, I get to tell a little story now. I gave myself a little window. When I was in undergrad at UCLA, and two of my fellow alum are here, Natalie and Monica, who you'll see in a little bit, rent and tuition, I used to work for this company called Party Pals. And it was this company where they would, you know, have all these different costumes and you'd like go entertain at kids' birthdays. And I did everything. I mean, back then it was like Ghostbusters, Ninja Turtles, Big Bird, you name them all. Like that was my life. And I would do, you know, some magic tricks they taught me or, you know, whatever, and play with the kids and all that good stuff. So lo and behold, this company was kind of not really legit. So the costumes were always called, they weren't a costume designer like my friend Angela. They were not so legit. So instead of Mickey Mouse, they would call it like Marty Mouse or, you know, So this one time, there was a new costume. I was like, what is this? And it was a giant purple dinosaur. And I was like, oh, Dino from the Flintstones, right? So, big mistake. I get my giant, you know, purple dinosaur costume, and I get to the party, and I can't even see. It's like, you know, trying to see out the eyes. And the mother's like, oh, come on, Barney, it's this way. And I'm like, Barney? I'm like, my name is Brian. And she's like, Barney, we're gonna entertain the kids. Come along. And I was like, all right, my name is Brian, but whatever. So she ushers me out to the lawn. I see all the kids. So I act like Dino and I start running around the lawn and I push him down. And I'm like, rawr, 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 rawr. And the mother was like horrified and she starts screaming. She's like, Barney. Barney, and she like grabs me and like ushers me out, and I'm like, I have no idea until I got home, and I was telling somebody the story, and then they introduced me to Barney, you know, the cleanup song and all that good stuff. So yeah, that was really that was a treat. That story has really nothing to do with this song, but I just wanted to tell it. It's a little song I love from The Most Happy Fella. Like a perfumed woman,
The wind blows in the bunkhouse like a perfumed woman, smelling of where she's been, smelling of Oregon cherries, or maybe Texas avocado, or maybe Arizona sugar beet. The wind blows in and she sings to me, 'cause I'm one of her rambling kin. She sings, Joey, 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 Joe. You've been too long in one place, and it's time to go, time to go. I've been bunking in, gets to feeling too soft and cozy. When the grub they've been cooking me gets to tasting too good. When I've had all I want of the ladies in the neighborhood, she sings, Joey, 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 Joe. You've been too long in one place, and it's time to go, time to go.
Thank you, thank you. Oh yes, all right. So this next performer, I am very excited to introduce you to. She and I became friends, I think maybe a few years ago. We're both in the events industry. As you know, California Magazine, number one DJ in Los Angeles. We have the number one planner, and we have other people that are amazing planners, and yeah, we love our events crew here. And she is one of the most incredible pop rock singers. Like, she can do anything. Like, you have to go to Sagebrush Cantina on a Sunday. She will, like, wow you. Like, she can sing anything. So when I asked her, I said, I'm doing this little Broadway cabaret. I was like, do you want to come do a Broadway song? And she's like, I'm up for the challenge. And she is amazing. So ladies and gentlemen, the lead singer of the Replicas Band, look it up, replicasband.com. Please welcome my friend, Veronica Puleo.
Do you want to stand? I think I want to stand. Hi. Yeah, give it up for this guy.
Oh, please.
Give it up for that guy. Wow. This is, look at you. You're like doing everything tonight.
Jack of all trades.
You're incredible.
Is that a good height for you?
It is so perfect. Right. Look at you. Right. Thank
fun.
You so much. You're
all
incredible.
Right. Please.
Isn't he incredible?
Thank you.
Oh. God, I've kissed a lot of frogs. And when I finally got my husband, I was like, I've been through so much. And I'm finally at this point where I need a little alone time sometimes. I won't need much. Just my own space. A little time with my own thoughts and my own space. Some place to run. Some place to hide. Where there is no one else but me to meet inside. I love you more than I can ever say. I love you more and more and more with every passing day. Allow me light, a breath of air. Leave me the only thing I own. We cannot share. Just leave me that sweet love of. My own space, and we'll be fine.
Veronica Puleo. All right. Well, you know, the introduction for this song is just as a DJ for almost 20 years now, I've probably played a million songs and I love them all and I've sang a lot of songs, but out of all the music, this is my favorite. This is my favorite song.
Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me a reason, and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Every man has his daydreams, every man has his goals, and people like the way dreams have of sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning, nightingales have their song. And don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. I gotta find my corner of the sky. And maybe some misty day you'll waken to find me gone. And far away you'll hear me singing till the dawn. You'll wonder if I'm happy there, a little more than I've been. And the answer will come back to you like laughter on the wind. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. I gotta find my corner of the sky.
Thank you. Thank you. I just love that song. It was the first song I sang for my... like, you know, when you have a voice teacher and you do like a little, what is that called, like a recital. And I remember my knees were shaking the whole time. That song's been with me my whole life. And speaking of incredible songs and musicians, so the next performer, as I was telling you about that Bedroom Bryan Lounge, so this next performer debuted this song in the Bedroom Bryan Lounge. And it was great because he like really like, you know, got into it, and we were all like really blown away. And he's one of my very close friends and a fellow singer and an incredible leading man. I've got to see him in a couple different productions. One of them was where he got to play the Phantom in the Maury Yeston version, if any of you musical theater people out there know that. And he's done several, big productions of Jekyll and Hyde, playing the title character. He even did Joseph, he told me. And he's just a great guy. You guys are in for a treat. And he's also a filmmaker, and he could tell you about that, but he's and a teacher, he's incredible. Ladies and gentlemen, my friend, Kelby Thwaits.
Darkness wakes. slowly, gently, music shall caress you. Grasp it, sense it, secretly possess you. Turn your face away from the garish light of day. Turn your thoughts away from cold, unfeeling light and listen to the music of the night. Close your eyes and surrender to your darkest dreams. Purge all thoughts of the life you knew before. Possess you. Open up your mind, let your fantasies unwind to the power of the music that I write. The power of the music of the night. Let your soul take you where your heart has meant to be. Leave all thoughts of the world you knew before. Let your soul take you where you long to be. Only then can you touch me, trust me, savor each sensation. Let the dream begin, let your darker side give in to the power of the music that I write. The power of the music of the night. You alone can make my song take flight. Help me make the music of the
Kelby Thwaits, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. All right, one more time. Give it up for him. All right, well, we're going to stay on the kind of ballad train. And this next performer I have known since, gosh, I was probably 1920, so it was just a couple years ago. No, we were undergrads at UCLA. Go Bruins. And it was a very incredible program under our tutorage by John Hall. And she's been performing around jazz clubs. And right after we graduated, actually, back in the 90s, I'll give it away. She was signed by Michael Jackson's label. She was part of this all-female R&B group called Brownstone, and they had some top 40 hits, and they were Grammy nominated, and they won a Billboard award, and you know, she's fancy like that. I'm just music theater guy. We've maintained our friendship, and a couple years ago, I think I actually kind of like nudged her to get performing again, and I'm so glad I did, because I've gotten to see her perform several times, and she's truly one of my favorite singers. Ladies and gentlemen, my friend Monica Doby Davis.
This guy. Can we give it up to Bryan, please? And it's true, I have to say that he is very instrumental in bringing me back to singing. It's been a while, so I'm just so happy to be here. Thank you. The trembling trees embrace the breeze tenderly. Then you and I came wandering breathlessly. Your arms opened wide and closed me inside. You took your lips, you breathlessly. The shore was kissed by sea and mist tenderly. I can't forget how to hearts met breathlessly. Your arms opened wide and closed me inside. You took my lips,
my love so breathlessly.
Right?
Monica
Doby Davis. Hello.
Thank you so much.
All right, you're doing your own show. All right, well, all right, so I told you, you know, those relationships were rocky for a long time. But lo and behold, 8 years ago, I met the love of my life. He's sitting right at that table there. And thanks to this woman, Ann Block, who I remember very well sitting down at the restaurant at Ruth Chris, and you know, you're like, just take your time, just because I was very like nervous about being in a relationship because I had never really been in one before. But something's working. We've been together 8 years, married six. So this is for Christian. Now that we're alone, may I tell you, I've been feeling very strange. Either something's in the air or else a change is happening in me. I think I know the cause. I hope I know the cause. From everything I've heard, there's only one cause it can be. Love, I hear, makes you smile a lot. Also, love, I hear, leaves you weak. Love, I hear, makes you blush and turns you ashen. You try to speak with passion and squeak. I hear, love, they say, makes you pine away, but you pine away with an idiotic grin. I pine, I blush, I squeak, I squawk. Today I woke too weak to walk. What's love? I hear, I feel, I fear I'm in. Ladies and gentlemen. And that's Sinead Turn.
La la la, ya ya dum da dum. See what I mean? Yaddy daddy daddy da. I hum a lot too. I'm dazed, I'm pale, I'm sick. I'm sore, I've never felt so well before. What's love? I hear, I feel, I fear. I know I am, I'm sure, I mean. I hope, I trust, I pray, I must be in. Forgive me if I shout. Forgive me if I crawl. I've only just found out, and well, I thought you ought to know.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Another round of applause for Stephen Applegate on the piano, Sammy on lights and sound. Hello, all our streamers out there. We got Chris and Ron helping us out. Thanks to all the staff here at Feinsteins. You've been amazing. Mwah, thank you. All right. Twist my arm. Thank you, guys. I really sincerely appreciate it. This has been such a crazy couple of weeks, and I'm so grateful that I got the chance to perform for all of you because it's my favorite thing to do. So we're going to do a little couple of Gershwin songs. Here we go.
Music is the magic that makes everything sunshiny. Dancing makes my troubles all seem tiny. When I'm dancing, I don't care if this old world stops turning, or if my bank is burning, or even if Romania wants to fight Albania. I'm not upset. No, I refuse to fret. Bad news, go away. Call round someday in March or May. I can't be bothered now. My bonds and shares may fall downstairs. Who cares? Who cares? I'm dancing and I can't be bothered now. I'm up among the stars, on earthly things I frown. I'm throwing off the bars that held me down. I'll pay the piper when times are riper. Just now I shan't, because you see I'm dancing and I can't be bothered now.
Yay! That song got me my 42nd Street European tour. I actually am a tapper. Several Singing in the Rain productions. And that's how Stephen and I met. I never told you. We did Singing in the Rain at the Glendale Center Theater. And back in 2007, I think. And I have some very special guests I'd like to bring up right now. They are part of the Bedroom Bryan Lounge tradition, so we could not do a show without them. So we're gonna welcome a little family trio. We have my friend, Jennifer Montague, her sister, Carrie Montague Barrett, and then, of course, her lovely daughter, Sutton Barrett. And they came all the way from New York, and then we practiced in my living room last night, and they just put this together. I'm so, it's amazing. So be nice to them, especially young Sutton. Yay, isn't she cute? Okay, so you're gonna take my mic, and then you.
Oh, okay.
You got yours, and then you're good. All right. Come on,
it's not simple to say. Most days I don't recognize me with these shoes and this apron. That place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true I was never attention, sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time, and she's all the things mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be
for. Sometimes life, it slips in through the back door and carves out a person who makes you believe it's all true. And now I've got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two for that girl that I knew,
who'd be reckless just enough, who gives her
growing stronger each day, till it finally reminds her to fight just a little, to bring back the fire in her eyes that's been gone but used to be mine. Used to be mine.
She is messy, but she is kind.
She is lonely most of the time.
She is all this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie.
She is gone, but she used to be mine.
Ladies and gentlemen, maybe they'll take it on the road like the Von Trapps. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Woo! All right. Well, we have one final song, and then we're going to do a little sing-along. All righty. Oh, there we go. Thank you, Stephen. Yeah. Another Gershwin.
The more I read the papers, the less I comprehend the world and all its capers and how it all must end. Nothing seems to be lasting, that isn't our affair. We've got something permanent, I mean in the way we care. It's very clear our love is here to stay. Not for a year, forever and a day. The radio and the telephone and the movies that we know may just be passing fancies, and in time may go. But, oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. In time, the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay, but our love is here to stay.
Ladies and gentlemen, Stephen Applegate.
The radio and the telephone and the movies that we know may just be passing fancies, and in time may go. But, oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. In time, the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay, but our love is here too. Our love is here too. Our love is here to stay.
Thank you so much. And now it's your time. I'm going to invite my friend Susan Edwards-Martin to come help me again when I grab her on the mic. And on your table, if there's not pasta sauce all over it now, we are going to sing Comedy Tonight.
And I'm going to come through the audience and give you all an opportunity to sing along. Okay?
All right. Are we ready, Stephen?
So sing out, Louise. Yeah.
Here we go. One, two, three.
Something familiar, something peculiar, something for everyone. want a comedy tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Something appealing, something appalling, something for everyone, a comedy tonight. Nothing with kings, nothing with crowns. Bring on the lovers, liars, and clowns. Old situations, new complications. Nothing portentous or polite. Tragedy tomorrow, comedy tonight.
You're amazing.
All right, one more verse.
Sing it out.
Here we go.
Something convulsive, something repulsive, something for everyone, a comedy tonight. Something aesthetic, something frenetic, something for everyone, a comedy tonight. Nothing of God, nothing of fate. Weighty affairs will just have to wait. Nothing that's formal, nothing that's normal.
Fabulous.
No recitations to recite.
You're amazing.
Open up the curtain. Comedy.
Gentlemen, one more time, Stephen Applegate on the piano, Sammy on lights and sound. I don't know, could we get all the performers to come up and take a bow? I don't know, or you don't have to if you don't want to, but if you want to, come up. Linda's okay.
Yeah,
Linda Kerns, give it up for her. Veronica Puleo, Kelby Thwaits, Susan Edwards Martin,
yeah.
Monica Doby Davis. The sisters galore, Jennifer,
Monica.
Sutton,
hi,
Carrie.
Great.
Am I missing
great.
Anybody? All right. Guys,
yeah.
Thank you so much. 1, 2, 3. Woo! All right. Thank you so
thank
much.
You.
All right. Maybe make sure to tip
be
your
safe.
Waiters. We all were one once. I know. All right. Or twice. All right. Thank you. Have a good night.